Who attacked you?
Smith.
B. Smith. They were found together, more or less.
And why did she attack you?
Well, was she trying to get your keys?
She tried to kill me.
Was this before or after the fire started?
After. Fire. A diversion.
Do you know who started the fire?
She did.
How do you know that?
She told me.
Thank you, Miss Ferguson. You've been very helpful.
If we can prove Officer Ferguson's allegations...
Oh, well, of course, we'll have to back her up with a bit of evidence. But it looks pretty certain that your B. Smith is going to be facing charges of arson and murder.
Morning.
Oh, hi. How are you feeling this morning?
Not bad. I'm sorry I made such a fool of myself last night.
Well, it's better than having someone else do it for you, huh?
I kept Tony back awfully late, didn't I?
He didn't mind at all, love. He wanted to make sure you were okay. Sarah, you're going to have to stop feeling sorry for yourself. I know you've had a rotten time, but there are a lot more people in the world who have a lot more bad luck than you've had.
I know. I've been thinking about it. I've never had a very high opinion of myself. That's why when Alan offered me a way out, I thought, why not? You and Tony have been so good to me. Everyone here has. You hardly know me. I guess... I think I owe it to you to try and act like a decent human being for a change.
That's the spirit, love.
There you are. I heard they let you come back here. I don't think you're going to get away with it. You murdered my son, and I'm going to see you pay for it.
Nobody murdered your son, Mr. Jeffries. He committed suicide.
And as for you, you can start packing now. When I get through, this place will be finished. You understand? Finished!
Mr. Jeffries, there's no way you can do that!
Hello, B. I'm Detective Sergeant Farmer. How are you feeling?
Mm-hmm.
Pretty lucky escape, eh?
Bloody lucky.
Now, B, I've got one or two questions I want to ask you about last night. It's just routine stuff, but you know how it is. It's got to be done.
Ask away.
Right. Have you got any idea how the fire started?
No.
I suppose you realised that Wentworth's pretty nearly written off?
Yeah, I figured that.
And that'll make you pretty pleased, I suppose.
What do you think?
Pleased enough to light it for yourself?
You better believe it.
And did you?
Well, I guess you're going to find out sooner or later. It wasn't me.
I'm afraid it's not a laughing matter, B. You're in very serious trouble. I don't think you realise that.
As I haven't done anything wrong, I don't see how I can be in any trouble. Unless, of course, you're trying to set me up.
Now, where were you when the fire started?
You tell me when it started. I'll tell you where I was.
Oh, come on, B. You're the top dog. Nothing happens here without your say-so.
Well, this did.
Well, shall I tell you how I see it? You and Officer Ferguson have been at one another's throats for quite some time, haven't you? Only finally it got too much for you. So you organised a couple of your girls to light the fire as a diversion while you got Ferguson up to isolation to fix her for good and all. Now, you're not denying that you fought with Ferguson, are you?
No. I had to. She wouldn't let me get away from the fire.
Only things got out of hand, didn't they? Ferguson was too much for you. And you didn't count on a couple of your mates getting killed.
What?
Oh, now, don't tell me the top dog didn't know about that either.
What are you talking about?
Barbara Fields and Heather Trapp. They were caught in the administration area. Now, as far as we're concerned, you are the number one suspect. Only this time it's not just arson. It's murder. So make things easy for yourself, B. cooperate, and I'll do what I can to help. Now, look, everybody understands what you've been going through. Worrying about your parole application, Ferguson on your back.
Look, you sanctimonious bastard. You wouldn't know if your ass was on fire unless you got official notification. Just piss off and leave me alone.
Well, B, I'd like you to just think about this. Unless you give me a good reason to chase somebody else, you're going to have to carry the can.
Get out of here. You make me sick.
All right, you lot, get on with it. Make it nice and shiny for the ladies. Come on.
This must be breaking your heart, Hudson. Pulling down your little love nest. Just wait till the boys get a hold of that little tart of yours. She'll be real second-hand by the time we get through with her. Don't ignore me, you bastard.
What the hell's going on here?
This bloody idiot here, Mr. Carlson.
All right, Hudson, if you can't handle the work without pulling over your own feet, report to the kitchen. I'll prepare meals for the women. Come on. Yes.
I haven't finished with you, Hudson.
What was that all about?
I'll tell you on the way to reception.
How's it all going?
Be ready for you soon.
Brooke.
Sir? I wouldn't like anybody else to have an accident while I was away. Understood?
Of course, sir.
Looks a nasty piece of work.
All the nastiest.
Well, if you don't move him to another division, he's only going to get hurt.
Colleen, the one thing you can't do in a men's prison is mollycoddle somebody. The moment the others get wind of it, his life becomes unbearable.
Well, there must be something you can do.
I'm afraid Hudson's the only one who can do anything about it. Coffee?
I don't think we've got time. Dismissed you here in a minute.
Your famous top dog, eh? Mm. She all right?
Must be. Hospital discharged her.
I think you'd better introduce us.
Mick, you know Jeff Carlson.
Oh, yes, hello.
How are you feeling, Smith?
No, not bad, Mrs. Powell. Not bad at all.
This is Mr. Carlson, the Deputy Governor.
Welcome to Woodridge, Smith.
Nice of you to make room for us, Mr. Carlson.
Righto, ladies, move over.
Hey! Oh, God, love, are you all right?
Yeah, great. When do we eat?
You're just in time for what they call lunch, courtesy of the Woodridge Hilton.
Yeah, what's going on here, Mrs. Morris? We can't keep eating out in that yard.
It's been attended to. You'll be having lunch in half an hour.
I've got a good idea. Why don't you put us all up for early parole? Then you wouldn't have to go to all this trouble.
Bloody hell. What a dump.
Yeah. We didn't realise how lucky we were at Wentworth.
And whose fault's that? I asked for a diversionary fire, not burn the whole bloody place down.
Oh, B, come on. I didn't mean for it to happen like that. Could have happened to anyone. Right, Margot?
Yeah, could have happened to anyone.
Trouble is, it happened to Mouse and Fields.
How are you feeling, Jenny?
Well, not too bad. He's coping all right.
Yeah? Well, we're not. Not in here, we're not.
Oh, now, don't go getting yourself into any trouble, Bea.
Since the cops are blaming me for Latham's little diversion, I haven't got much to lose, have I?
You think they'd do better than this, wouldn't you?
They will.
It's like everything else in this place. Slack.
Oh, come on, at least it's not raining.
Oh, not yet. Mrs. Powell, are we expected to eat this garbage?
What's wrong with it?
It stinks!